me that she wants me. Told me that she wants me. For no crying, I'm in a sea.
And hopefully this listening session would basically show us what type of guy he is. We all know that he's talented. We all know that he hits bars for days. And we all know that he's a Soweto boy. So he's representing right now. So yeah, thank you very much. Hope you enjoy this listening session. And hope you enjoy the album as well. I'm gonna hand over to
Maggz
and hand over to Mr. X.
Fly. Man, I think I should take her. I fly. Felt her move behind me, whispering she likes me. I take it without you. Never felt a vibe like this. Never been this hype like this. You hear me though? Cause I got Johnny, my love. She haven't got me, my love. If you wanna go, never felt a vibe like this. Show you when we get to the crib.
I can't wait to share the album with you guys, you know. There's a lot of people to thank who made all of this possible tonight, and I'll thank them as the show progresses. But yeah, I want us to get to the music. We'll do it fast. I know people like to. They said, "Oh, you must explain every song," but I don't believe in that. I believe music is like self-explanatory, you know? You get the message within the music. If it's good enough, it crosses to you. If it's not, then maybe not. But yeah, man, thank you everybody for coming through. Yeah, man, means a lot, man. Shout out to everybody who was involved to making this night extra special. We changed venues, but you guys still pulled through. That's love to an MAW, you feel me? Yeah, shout outs, man. Yes, look, we're gonna go through the album right now. My album is a 14-track album. It's called FLAG. It's an acronym for like for love and glory. And when I mean for love, I'm not only talking about girls, I am though, but it's my love for the game, my love for hip-hop, my love for friends, my love for my enemies too, you know? And when I mean glory, it's my achievements, things I've achieved, things I'm still wanna achieve, and yeah, you know, the glory that comes with it. So that's why I call FLAG, and I'm waving it up for Soweto. That's my hood. That's where I hail from.
She told me that she wanna bring a friend with. She heard that I don't fuck, man, I just so touch.
Like, I know people know me for these like gritty lyrics and all this stuff that I used to do, you know. I still do it, but you know, I feel like I grew musically all over the years, you know. And I've always had this melody side of my music style. It's just, I guess I never appreciated it more back then, but now I'm just embracing it fully, you know.
Big time, big time, big time. Yeah, one time, one time, one time. Big time, all I need is one time, then I'm done. Yeah, big time. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Big shout out to PH, man. Shout out.
I make that time off my life. Yeah, big time, big time.
It's a journey, you know. It's a personal album from Maggz's perspective. He's grown specifically from a music point of view, you know. It's been a long time since he released a full project. So I think it's really a sit down listening project to see where he's been, what he's been doing, and his growth musically overall. So musically, it's growth, you know, and the music has grown as well from back in the day to what it is right now. You can see that in the music.
She's so mean, who hates, she's gorgeous. That's big. Are you ready for it?
Hi, Maggz from Mkdala Namasimba. I've listened to the album before. I just came here to support more than anything. Yeah, you know. I'm a chitabayazi, yo. Like Maggz, his drums, Jakafula, Injaka cool, you know. Hey, this thing's good, yeah, it's just too easy.
Oh, Lord, I thank you. Big money make it shit fine. Knew you was there for me, Lord. Big money was the big sign. Big time. Cause everything comes in a set time.
Probably one of my favorite rappers in SA. if not number one. That's just the way it is, period. So I'm just happy that he's finally on his feet. He's been through a lot of downs. I'm glad, you know, fucking trials is gonna be tribulations. And this is the tribulation right here, is the album Flag.
Big time, big time, big time, big time. Big time, yeah. One time, one time, one time. Big time, all I need is one time, then I'm done, yeah. Big time, yeah, yeah.
Because Maggz is finally dropping his album! They called you a Mabala Sun or something like that. Are you gonna sponsor my next project because you just had a nice chair? What's good, Maggie?
But no, man, Mabala, we have like a distribution situation. I'm not like artist or whatever, you know. So a distribution situation is more like a business collusion of some sort. Not like Trump and Russia, but you know, something like that.
Got a sexy woman trying to take a swim into the ocean looking
big time.
Ass fat with them thick thighs, got a chest out looking
big time.
And she just told me that it's dick time. Making movies for your quick.
This guy here, Tina, I went to this album of my hardcore, I'm telling you, I'm going to go to the shit. I'm telling you, I'm telling you,
big time, all I need is one time, then I'm done, yeah. Big time, yeah, 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 yeah. Big time, big time, big time, big time.
You know, we're gonna do 16 cities, and then, yeah, we're gonna promote the album, we're gonna bring the album to the people. Two must turn it up on me, yes, everywhere, your city, or whatever, or group, or sample malang, or selling popo, I'll buy me, yes, I'll
big time.
Looking at time through the walls and pedals were great.
Why don't you tell everybody why I caged up the group? Huh? You stuck with his girl, nigga.
No, that's a BS. That never happened. Tito, what?
I would never do that.
Wait, my last album and this one. And I just want to say one thing, it's not like I wasn't doing music this whole time. There's a lot of music that went through. Sometimes I just felt like I was an unlucky guy, because I did my second album, the computers had messed up. I did my second album, I went through a court case with some asshole who's not my friend no more. But yeah, you know what I mean? So like a lot of things, every time I wanted to drop something, it just would happen. It just impede my stuff. And I understood the fans' frustration. I was frustrated as much as they were. Like, yo, man, why aren't you dropping? Like, fam, you think I don't want to drop? I want to fucking drop. I got all this fucking music I've been making, and I got all these fucking features. I want to put myself out there so people know who I am as myself, not just known as a feature guy. I hated that. Like, I'm not just a feature guy. I'm like, call me. If only you knew. Like, sometimes I wish you sat with us in the fucking studio. You call me a feature guy. You understand? But that's not the point. The point is, God is great, my man. You know, I never came up. I could have just easily said, fuck this whole thing. You know, it's not working out. But I stayed in it. You know, I stayed in it. I'm here now. That's why I decided to release this music as well. I could have edited, and I would have released my album in 2019. But I decided to keep it as it is, put this project together, let people hear where I was, where, you know, as a musician, I was at the time. You know what I mean? So I appreciate that. I want people to also, in my next party, where I am, 2017, 2018, let people clap in the ears. I'm sitting around, and you know, I appreciate the support. So thank you for your here today. You could have been anywhere else. You could have been here today. You could have been spending some money on my time. You know what I'm saying?
We just making music, so I'm just happy that we got to this stage where people appreciate what we're making, whether it's trap,
with this what, with this what. People just appreciate the music. So that means a lot to us, you know? And shout out to 411, man.
One more, dog. Is this your best output?
Hey, that's a difficult question, man. Like, I think where I am musically now, or where I was in 2016 when I made this stuff, this is where best musically is where I was. Where it's like, okay, nobody's here, but I'm here. You know what I mean? And I just want people to hear 2017 Maggz, but yo, listen, forget that. Still enjoy 2016 Maggz with this album, but 2017 Maggz could be even a little bit more special, you know? I can't wait to take it out, but you'll hear 2017 Maggz in 2018. That's why you're hearing 2016 Maggz in 2017. So 2017 Maggz coming right straight to you, 2018, you know what I'm saying? Early this time. We ain't doing this late in the year. We're doing Feb, we're doing March. You know, we're doing early. So shout out to everybody who's been a fan. Yeah, showing love, man. Shout out to 411, man. You know what I'm saying? Real niggas.
One more, dog.
Yeah, let's go.
One more.
Do you feel you got, like, a song of the year from this album? Personally?
I felt like... I'll tell you something. I felt like Valle is a groundbreaking song. You know what I mean? It's on a level of its own. I played it for 1,000 people from South Africa, from elsewhere in Africa, and it resonates with the people, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like Valle has the potential to supersede a lot of things. I just need to put visuals behind it, but yeah, man, I think Valle is the one. And I got Paporis, one of Africa's best, so you can't even fault the brother. We nice.
We done with you, nigga. We done with you. Enjoy yourself, dog.
Thank you, man.